Alright, what's going on, you country cruisers? Welcome back to Travel in America, where on this episode, we get to do one of our favorite things of all time, and that's Travel America. So we're about 60 miles out of Chicago, still in Indiana. We went home for Thanksgiving to see some family and some friends, you know, drink some beers, have a good time. One of the main reasons we went back is to get a very special something, which is that truck that's sitting right behind me. So, let me introduce you to Ground Force 2 here. Got a couple issues, you know, nothing serious, nothing crazy. I mean, it's a little bent in on the quarter panel there. May or may not have a rear leak in. I know it's got a rear main leak in, a control arm, an upper control arm's pretty bent up. It doesn't have windshield wipers. The windshield got cracked and just a bunch of shit like this, you know, whatever. I mean, she's not a show truck. We're not on the way to SEMA. So, what does it say? 55? Yeah, 55. We were hitting 85 just a minute ago. She cruises fine. So, yeah, it's like 10:20. We gotta be back at work 2 days from now at noon. And I'd like to get a good nap in before work, because then I'll be grumpy. We're definitely going to be hitting Chicago tonight, Madison, Wisconsin. Haven't really decided what route I'm going to go. Either 94 or 90. We'll check for weather when we get up there. Where's your fish at? I'll be damned. Oh my gosh, get over here with that fish. That has got to be the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life. Terrific work. Terrific work, buddy. Are you ready to do some traveling? You know what it's like to do some road tripping, buddy. Yeah, good boy.
Took a look down a westbound road. Right away I made my choice. Headed out to my big two-wheeler. I was tired of my own voice. Took a beat on the northern plains and just rolled that power on. Twelve hours out of Mackinac City, stopped in a bar to have a brew. Met a girl, we had a few drinks, and I told her what I decided to. Looked out the window a long, long moment, then she looked into my eyes. She didn't have to say a thing. I knew what she was thinking. Roll me away, won't you roll me away tonight? I too am lost, I feel double crossed. I'm sick of what's wrong and what's right. We never even said a word, we just walked out and got on that bike. And we rolled. And we rolled clean out of sight. Great divide. I could
could go east, I could go west. It was all up to me to decide. Just then I saw a young hawk flying and my soul began to rise. And pretty soon my heart was singing, roll, roll me away, I wanna roll me away tonight. Gotta keep rolling, gotta keep riding, keep searching till I find what's right. And as the sunset faded, I spoke to the faintest first star. I said, next time.
Shift, wasn't it, buddy? Golly. All right, so last night we made it through Chicago, we made it through Madison, and I slept right on the border of Minnesota. So once we get to North Dakota, it's just a long, long shot. We're on the same road pretty much all the way back to Bozeman, so we'll just freaking keep at it. God damn, I'm bored. Nothing's falling off the Jeep yet. That's a pretty good sign. Spoiler alert, Minnesota's pretty freaking boring. I mean, unless you just love lakes. We're gonna do some road tripping tips, or tips from road tripping. I don't know what I'm gonna call it yet. Basically, what you'd call me and Rocky are professional road trippers. So we're really good at driving around. So we're gonna share some of our tips since we're about to pull into North Dakota, and that's like a 6-hour nightmare of nothingness. You know, I hate to break it to anybody that was like planning a big destination trip to North Dakota. Kind of sucks. Rule number one is don't be stupid, okay? I mean, if you're just gonna come out and be stupid, then just stay home. Examples of being stupid on the road. If you're driving through New Mexico and you wait till you have a quarter of a tank of gas to look for a gas station, just ask yourself, is that stupid? The answer is yes, so don't do that. It's real simple. Treat a half a tank of gas like it's a quarter tank of gas. Better yet, just treat 3/4 of a tank of gas like a quarter tank of gas, and you'll be just fine. Just stop at every 5 gas stations. I've cut it close a couple of times, but that's because I was stupid, okay? I have no problem admitting I used to be stupid. I learned the hard way. And you don't want to be one of those guys that's like carrying around a gas tank full of gas in their car. You know, just in case I'm stupid and forget to get gas, I have this tank of gas in the back. And when you pull over at night to rest, and you and your dog wake up in the middle of the night higher than draft balls on gas fumes because you didn't shut the lid because, you know, you were worried that you were going to be stupid. So just don't be stupid in the first place. Let's see, another hot tip. Always talk to strangers. You know, everyone's such a little weenie nowadays about that one. I don't know how else you find all the good shit around town. I mean, you just bank on Google, you just look around. It's like, no, you're ignorant if you think that you're just that intelligent to where you know the hotspot of everywhere you're going. You don't, okay? So just swallow your pride and go talk to some strangers. Talk to the really weird looking stranger. First thing you want to do when you meet that stranger is you're going to want to exchange phone numbers with them and add them on Facebook. Once you've added them on Facebook and exchanged phone numbers, you're going to ask them, hey, what's the best restaurant in town? He's probably going to tell you. And if he has anything he forgot to tell you, that way he can get a hold of you, you know, once you guys split ways. But definitely exchange information with strangers. If you're worried about some self-defense. That honestly brings me to my next rule is, you know, just don't even bother looking at state carry laws. You know, most of them don't transfer over anyway. And if the cop finds out that you are aware that you're breaking the law and you're breaking the law, then you're definitely screwed. So just act like you're dumb. Don't look at them in the first place so you don't even know any better. And then when you get caught, you're like, dude, I have no idea that was a thing. That's exactly what I did at work. So just completely ignore carry laws in the United States and just do your thing. But if you don't like guns, which a lot of people don't, you know, girls carry pepper spray and stuff, a tiny little inhaler tank of pepper spray, you know what? I probably would be afraid of strangers too. So here's a hot tip from Travel in America. You're going to be cruising the country. You don't like firearms. You're scared of strangers. Here's what you need to do. You need to get somewhere either on Amazon or somewhere in the Rocky Mountains, maybe even the Smoky Mountains. You're going to want to go ahead and just get yourself a can of bear spray. I don't care who you are. If you see some chick with this on her hip, or a guy, you know, maybe you're a guy and you're scared of strangers, I don't know. If this is on your hip, nobody's coming to mess with you, okay? If you got your pepper spray on your keychain, I mean, imagine if you have more than one attacker. Then what are you going to do? I doubt that little inhaler tank of pepper spray is going to take down multiple grown men or women. But now this thing, you just give them the old fire extinguisher. I mean, just hose them down. I mean, just hose them down. And that works every time. I have yet to see a video of anybody just get bear sprayed and continue doing whatever they were doing before that. So, hot tip, wherever. You don't have to be in the mountains. You don't have to be anywhere even around bears. Just carry bear spray. You're in the mall. Who is coming up to you and messing with you in the mall if you have a fire extinguisher attached to your head? Another tips from the road trips is always have defense on your vehicle. You know, nothing's worse than being in a position on the interstate where you're having it out with this guy or gal, you know, for miles, for hours, you know. You're going to the same place, so you're bickering back and forth. There's nothing worse than that person winning the fight, you know, and getting ahead of you. So if there's any way you can have some sort of defense on your car, get that installed immediately. I mean, take out your whole rear wiper if you have to and just hook the hose up. That's what I did. And now, whenever people piss me off and I get road rage, all I'm thinking about is, golly, I just gotta get ahead of this guy. And once I'm ahead of this guy, I'm turning this button loose. I don't think you can see it. I'm gonna just squirt it all over my Comanche. Yep. Yep. Another hot tip is if you're pulling a trailer like I am right now, this would be probably the fourth trailer I've pulled out to Montana. All different shapes and sizes. Like this one, I've never pulled one of these before. It's not too heavy, but if you have any questions about what you're pulling, just stop asking yourself that and just hit the road, okay? Nobody likes a paranoid road tripper. Stopping at every rest stop, checking all your straps. Just tighten your straps the first time and then just don't look at them until you get to your destination. They were tight when you left, they're gonna be tight when you get there. So it's just one of those things where you're gonna ruin yours and everybody else's time if you're constantly talking and worrying and stopping about checking your load and, oh, is my truck capable of pulling this? Or is it too heavy? Or maybe I should get trailer brakes? Those are all kind of useless questions, and you'll figure that out once you just hit 80 on the interstate. That answers everything really in about 30 seconds. You'll have all your answers. So another hot tip is when you're packing your, you know, survival bag or you're going hiking or backpacking or what have you, it's always important to carry at least one or two squeaky balls. You know, just the wee-wee. If you have a couple of those, I mean, it could just very well save your life from potential danger. And it covers all aspects, you know, wolves, bears, hell, moose, you know, mountain lions. All they are bigger versions of our pets, and so it's just in their DNA to not be able to resist that ball. So if you're in the woods and you come across a bear, you know, pull that thing out and give it a couple whacks and throw it that way and you go that way. You know, if you're in thick lion country, I'd probably go with like a ball of yarn over that ball, but most toys with squeakers in them will work. It's just best to have that with you, because if you don't have one of those, you're gonna bank on using your bear spray. Fargo, North Dakota.
down, sweet mama. Whoa, sweet mama, don't let me down.
I got the Holy Ghost fire and it's burning in me. I got the Holy Ghost fire and it's burning in me. Got the Holy Ghost fire and I'm burning down the streets. I got a sweet little baddie and she's rolling in the caddy with me. I got a sweet little baddie and she's rolling a caddy with me. I got a whole lot of plotter for my Holy Ghost mama and she's making sweet eyes for me. Don't let me down, sweet mama. Oh, sweet mama, don't let me down. Let me down. Coming on, let's pray. Dying to get you in the palm of my hand. Working the long con plan. Don't let me down, sweet mama. Oh, sweet mama, don't let me down. Coming on, this way. Dying to get you in the palm of my hand. Working the long con plan. If you knew the truth about me, baby girl, no way in hell you'd stay. But if I filled your hand, would you take it to the grave? Cause a secret ain't no secret if you give it all away.
In the palm of my hand.
Well, I guess we're following these cows now. You gotta move on, mama. Come on now. Oh, wipe out. Rockies, baby, come on. Swing it or don't bring it, you know the rule. Come on, baby. That's pretty. Personally, thank you for joining my mission to rescue the Comanche and get her back to the mountains. Hope you enjoyed it. And ride along with us next time as we do what the hell ever we want to do, because that's what we do. We travel in America, baby. Swing it or don't bring it.